What up, viewers? What up? What up? Today is Saturday, May 11th, and I just, as always, I want to talk about some video game news. What happened this week in the realm of video games? Just time for a quick recap of the week. Starting with yesterday, we got new, or no, not yesterday. Thursday was the second PlayStation State of Play, the Nintendo Direct type of the Nintendo Direct of PlayStation, and they showed off a few big things. They started off strong by showing off Monster Hunter World. Their next expansion was coming out in September, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong. And yeah, it looks awesome. I haven't played Monster Hunter in quite a bit, but if you are still playing it, good on you, because they've definitely been rolling out lots and lots of good content. So maybe not so much a good job for PlayStation, but good job on Capcom for keeping that game alive and keeping it going. Then they had a bunch of smaller titles. They had an up-res version of Medieval, which I've never interacted with. So tell me your thoughts on that below. What else did they have? They had a game where you played as a possum type creature, and you're just trying to stay alive and survive in the wilderness. They had a asymmetrical predator game, which I would have liked to see more of. All they showed was like a trailer and a title card, or like not even a trailer, but just like a title card. It's not coming till 2020, so I bet we'll see something more on that later. Trying to think of other things that they showed off. Their big capstone was Final Fantasy VII Remake, and the game looks awesome. I haven't interacted much with Final Fantasy because it was always PlayStation exclusive, and I grew up as a Nintendo Xbox kind of guy. It's just those were the consoles I had in my house, so I never interacted with PlayStation too much, or PlayStation exclusives like Final Fantasy very much. But this looked awesome. I never interacted with Resident Evil very much, and now I have Resident Evil 7 and Remake. So this just gives me another opportunity to interact with something that's, you know, has a pretty strong legacy. They also had a new console that they were showing off. It was like steel gray. It had like Xbox, or blah, blah, blah. It had PlayStation symbols all over it. Yeah, it looked pretty cool. But consoles aren't really doing it for me. I just read an article this morning that PlayStation's looking at a release, or industry and analysts have speculated that the PlayStation 5 will be out in October next year and it'll cost $500. So even if my PlayStation 4 Pro was crapping out, I'd probably just wait until the PlayStation 5 comes out. So new console didn't get me too much hype, but I do like the steel gray color. But yeah, these sort of like state of plays have been kind of hitting me funny. I mean, I've said a couple times, like, Nintendo Directs haven't been doing very much for me because they've only been showing off like five titles that I don't really engage with. But I have been praising the Nindies because they've been showing off like 30 titles, and, you know, even if there's only five or six titles that I like of them, that's still way more things for me to interact with. And they're just so short. These were so bite-sized. I feel like Nintendo Directs are a little bit longer. This one was only like 13 or 14 minutes long. And I don't know. This hasn't felt like a good replacement for like an E3 showcase. I'm pretty sure that PlayStation, if they wanted to, could put on an hour's worth of content talking about video games at E3. And the fact that they're skipping and they've been doing these just hasn't been making up for them. Those are my thoughts on the state of play. Let me know what you think of them down below. I know I missed a couple games, but tell me what games you liked from PlayStation State of Play this week. Moving on, Dead Cells, the hit, one of the best games of last year. I think, what did it win? Best action game? Something like that, or best indie game. I forget which video game award it won last year. But it's coming to mobile, which I could see that. Like, there's only so many buttons that you can press. You can already use like a sideways Switch controller. And once you port it to Switch, I'm pretty sure it's pretty quick and easy to port it to mobile, but correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, Dead Cells is being ported to mobile, which is awesome. I wonder how much it'll cost on mobile, if it'll be a different price point, if there won't be a price point, there'll just be some kind of microtransaction. I don't know how you, yeah, the mobile market's weird. and that's all I have to say about that. Also coming to mobile is my favorite battle royale, Apex Legends. Apex Legends is also coming to mobile, just like Fortnite and PUBG before it. I would assume it would play. Yeah, there's same, you know, run, shoot, move around. I don't know. I've interacted with Fortnite on mobile, and that wasn't a fun experience. So hopefully Apex can do something right, or do something better. Not right. They already do a bunch of stuff right. But yeah, Apex Legends also coming to mobile. Moving on, I saw a John Wick video game is coming out. It looks like a semi-real-time, semi-turn-based strategy game where you like duck and dive and dodge around corners and like you can, you know, real-time select one of two options and then that's what he executes. Looks pretty fun, but I always know that video games based on movies have always been kind of a crapshoot. So I hope it does well. I could imagine actually that the gameplay, once you've like fully executed like this plan, if it like runs you through and then you feel like you've executed a John Wick like choreography scene in a movie, because those things are freaking outrageous. And I am excited for John Wick 3 coming out soon, but or is it? It's not already out, is it? No. I would have had way more people talking to me about how good it is. But yeah, movie-based video games, kind of So, moving on, there was IGN, I believe. We'll check. IGN put out an article that was a catch-up of all of the... IGN. Put out an article talking about catching you up on the Borderlands trilogy, you know, everything that's happened in Borderlands, the Borderlands series since up until Borderlands 3 comes out. I didn't play too much of the prequel sequel, so knowing some of that information was pretty cool. But it did have Tales from the Borderlands information, and I haven't played that since like it came out, I think. And it's also one of my favorite Borderlands games. So tell me what you think of Tales from the Borderlands. I actually wanted to do cosplay for the main guy, Ryze, I think. Or Reese, or however you say his name. I thought he had really cool cosplay. So I wanted to do that, but I never did. Maybe I will. But yeah, it sums up the whole Borderlands series in like 5 minutes to catch you up for Borderlands 3. Borderlands 3 is coming in... September 13th. I'm excited for that, so get hyped for that. Next, it seems like the clans for Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines 2, they're slowly trickling those out, and this week we got information on Tremere. Tremere are the blood magic, the blood mages of the Vampire Masquerade universe. It was pretty cool to... I like the art style, and then at the end of every trailer, it also shows like a little bit of like pre-alpha gameplay and like the whole like, you know, making people explode with blood magic and like, you know, drawing signs on the ground. Looks pretty cool. I'm super excited for that. And then I keep forgetting and then re-remembering that at the end of every trailer it says Q1 2020, so looking forward to that. Hope that doesn't slip at all. I always need a good Q1 RPG game to get me started on my year in video games. Moving on, Bethesda is not giving up on making fun of Walmart Canada. I think Walmart Canada leaked Rage 2 probably almost close to exactly a year ago. And they have a Xbox controller that has like the Walmart Canada leak on it, like a sticker on it, and they're selling those or giving them away or something. It's pretty funny. It's immortalized now. Now that it's on a controller, it can never go away. Walmart Canada, you leaked so much. Gave us plenty of good information, but Bethesda is not letting you live it down for leaking their stuff. but that's pretty funny. And last but certainly not least, Steam is having a sale on Pathfinder Kingmaker. I actually played through the campaign of Pathfinder Kingmaker, or not through it. I played half of the campaign in the tabletop version of Pathfinder, and I've been wanting to get into a good RPG game for a while. And so I think it was 50% off. Let me double check that real quick. But yeah, 50% off. So if you're looking for a good RPG game, if you've interacted with Pathfinder at all, Kingmaker is probably one of the best adventures that you can play in Pathfinder. And the fact that it's on Steam, 50% off, I'll give you something to buy. Cool. That was my quick recap of the week. Thank you for watching me on Twitch. A like goes, or a follow and a subscribe goes a very, very, very long way. I appreciate all my followers and all my subs. If you're watching this on YouTube, I usually port it a day later, but since I'm doing this on Saturday morning, I will be uploading it now. So yeah, thank you for watching. Hope you have a great day. Hope you have a super weekend. Hope you have a super day. Bye.